Now we will see the grouping of cells in different ways. As like in the resistors, cells are also grouped in two ways, series and parallel. Grouping of cells. First one, series combination. Whenever two or more cells are connected in series, what will be its effective EMF and what will be its effective internal resistance? We are going to see now. Let us take two cells. Which are connected in series. This is the starting point A. After crossing the first cell, the point is B. After crossing the second cell, the point is C. Now I want to find out the potential difference between the points A and C. But between A and C, one point is there, B. That's why. Let me find out the potential difference between A and B first. Next, B and C. The sum of these two will give the potential difference between A and C. Therefore, potential difference between the terminals A and B is equal to, we can write VAB. The formula is V at A minus V at B. But this cell has EMF E1 and internal resistance R1. Second cell has EMF E2, internal resistance R2. There is no charge here at A. And no power or no cell or no potential is applied at A. So VA minus V1, VB, we can get E1 minus I R1. Then, what is the potential difference between the terminals B and C? Potential difference between the terminals B and C. Again, it is VBC, VB minus V at C. At C also there is no potential, but between B and C, one cell is connected, that is a cell of E2 EMF and R2 internal resistance. That means it will be E2 minus I R2. Now I want to find out VAC. VAC is nothing but VA minus VC. How to find out the VA minus VC? This equation 1 plus this equation 2. Like that we will get the potential difference between A and C. Now we will see the result. VA minus VB is E1 minus IR1. Let us say this is equation 1. Such like that VB minus VT, VC is equal to E2 minus IR2. Let us say this is equation 2. Now I am adding the equations 1 and 2. On the right hand side we will get V of A minus V of B plus V of B minus V of C is equal to, on the left hand side this is expression. What is the right hand side expression? E1 minus IR1 plus E2 minus IR2. Now we will see, minus VB plus VB get cancelled out. This is V of A minus V of C is equal to, we can write E1 plus E2 minus of I into R1 plus R2. What is VA minus VC? Nothing but the potential difference between the terminals A and C. Therefore, VAC is equal to E1 plus E2 minus of I into R1 plus R2. May I write E1 plus E2 is equal to E equivalent minus I into R equivalent. So what we can understand, when two cells are combined in series combination, their equivalent EMF will become the sum of individual EMFs. Their equivalent internal resistance will become the sum of individual internal resistances. So the rules will be like follows. Now we will see the rules in the series combination. We got E equivalent is equal to E1 plus E2, and R equivalent we got R1 plus R2. So what is the expression? Now see, the E equivalent is E1 plus E2. So what is the rule? The effective EMF in the series combination of cells is equal to the sum of individual EMFs. So E equivalent is equal to sum of individual EMFs, E1 plus E2. If it is for N cells, we can write up to so on EN. That's it. Same is valid for the effective internal resistance also. So the second rule is like this. The effective internal resistance in the series combination of cells is equal to the sum of individual internal resistances. So R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. This is for one, this is for two. If it is there are N cells, we can write up to so on. Now we will see the parallel combination of two cells. So how it will look like? Yeah, there is a common point, one cell, parallelly with this one more cell. The junction, this is C, this is A. This is continue. So this is B1, this is B2. These are two cells which are connected in parallel. This is the first cell, contains E1 EMF, internal resistance R1. Second cell, E2 EMF, R2 internal resistance. Now what we should find out, this is the direction of current. Whenever I amount of current is touches the B2, it splits into two paths. In this direction it is I1, in this direction it will be I2. We know that in parallel combination of resistors or cells, I is equal to I1 plus I2. So first we will find out the I value. With respect to that, we will get E and R both. Now please listen. What is the potential difference between B1 and B2 in the direction of first cell? PD between B1 and B2 in the direction of first cell is equal to, we can write E1 minus I1 R1 is nothing but the V of B1 minus V of B2. Next one, the potential difference between B1 and B2 in the direction of second cell. PD between B1 and B2 in the direction of second cell, that is equal to E2 minus I2 R2, that is nothing but V of B1 minus V of B2. So this is V, this is also V. We know that I is equal to I1 plus I2. For I is equal to I1 plus I2. What is the expression of I1 from this equation? This is 1, this is 2. From equation 1, what is the equation? V is equal to E1 minus I1 R1. I1 is equal to, from this, E1 minus V by R1. Similarly, I2 is equal to E2 minus V by R2. Now we are going to substitute this I1 and I2 values in this equation. Let us give one number to this equation, equation number 3. We know that I is equal to I1 plus I2. Now I am substituting this I1 and I2 values in the equation. Therefore, I is equal to, what is I1? E1 minus V by R1. What is I2? E2 minus V by R2. Now we can write E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus of V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Because R1 and R2 are the common elements, we can take them as a common and LCM. So this expression will become like this: E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 R2 minus V into R2 plus R1 by R1 R2. So what is this one? E equivalent, this one R equivalent. With respect to that, we will get the I equivalent. Therefore, E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 R2 is equal to E equivalent. The short form of the E equivalent is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. Next, this one is R equivalent. This is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, right? So R equivalent is equal to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So this is 1 by, this is R equivalent is equal to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, that is equal to R2 plus R1 by R1 R2. With these two expressions, we are going to find out the current of the circuit which is flowing through the cells.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.